Yeah, I didn't watch it live. I watched it afterwards. No, I've watched all of the games over the last week of the season. Very interesting side. I thought they had a lot of ups and downs in the season, but they've certainly hit their form over the past few weeks. I thought they mauled pretty well. Obviously Banyaki gives them a lot of momentum. I thought their back three were very good in the air and on counter attack. No, they're a side that thrives on momentum and physicality. They clean out the breakdown quite wide, which is something that we'll have to have a look at in terms of taking players out. But all credit to their coaching staff. They also made a slow start, new coach taking their time, but they've really hit their straps and it'll be a big game.
Will we see many changes for next Saturday? What's the position with injuries and things?
Yeah, well, you'll see multiple changes again. We said three games in 11 days, especially with Europe coming up. So we're going to make multiple changes again, giving certain guys chances. Injury-wise, there's a whole list. We've got an injury in almost every position: prop, hooker, tight head prop, lock, all three loose forwards. Only position we've got a nine as well, Jack Stafford out. 10, 12, we've got an injury in every position. So very frustrating as a coach. You want to have your best players playing. The good thing about this is we've put ourselves in a position to compete in Europe for a quarter-final place, and we're in a good position in our pool in a Pro 14. That's still a long way to go. So just take it week by week, and hopefully by March and April we'll be in a good position to fight for playoff spots.
Yeah. Going from the highs of beating Leicester away at Welford Road, and now the two tough games and two losses over the Christmas period. What's the spirit in the camp like?
The spirit's very good, sir. I think that's the beauty of rugby. You are going to win and you are going to lose. I think reaction is the one that you're looking for as a coach. Now, after Leinster, the players themselves were very disappointed with the start they made. We had the plan in place. And we said, listen, that was going to be a big focus point for us against Ulster, and that's what I'm proud of. We came out firing 17-0 up. It could have been 24 at halftime. That's what you look for in a response. Everybody knew that we possibly did enough to win the games in terms of creating opportunities. But like I said before, if you don't keep 15 players in the field, it's very difficult to win in rugby games. And if you lose players in any sport on a numbers game, you're going to find it hard to win.